Good morning, Judge. Good morning. Thank you. Better. As I walked down the aisle this morning, I was sitting here listening to Martha, and I was like going, am I graduating again? Am I inheriting more student debt? What else can I get put on me besides Karen's remodel and me working till I'm 900? Anyway, whew, I got that off. We're good. Hey, hello, I'm Craig Atkins, and welcome to the Jacksboro Parish, where we are passionate about our faith of worship and passionate about our service. We're glad you are here in person, or if you're joining us online. If you're online with us, drop a comment, let us know how we're doing. We'd love to hear your response and get feedback from you so we can make adjustments or do things better to make you happy. I'd like to share with you some announcements regarding the life within and outside of the parish. Please remember to look into your pew, right or left of yourself, and find that red folder. Please fill out that information so we can have a record of your attendance. And if you're visiting, we can make sure that we can reach out to you and keep you involved in what we're doing here at the parish. Vacation Bible School, July 8th and 11th. If you'd like to help with Vacation Bible School, please make sure you see Karen Davenport. Okay. Mother's Day Out, Father and Daughter Dance next Saturday at the Twin Lakes Activity Center. The theme is Darlings and Daddies. Pull on your boots and dance the night away. If you'd like to help with donations, please contact Tyressa in the front office and she'll take care of you. I think it's always a good event that we have, and it's nice to support that activity for what we do for our community. The food pantry in April, we're collecting all canned meats. Ravioli, Spam, and beef stew, etc. Kind of gets you, doesn't it, Devo? Whew! I guess it could be. All right, let's come together and, this is on me, guys. I need to tell you this. I printed off the wrong bulletin. I'm only human, which is rare for me to ever make a mistake, but I printed off March information on birthdays, so I'm going to cover myself by going, if you're having a birthday this month or this week, happy birthday to you. Monty, don't get mad. If it's your birthday, I'll call your name out, Monty. It's okay. I know how you get. So that's on me, but happy birthday to those that are celebrating a birthday today or this week or heading in next Sunday, okay? Good. Well, guys, we are scraping the bottom of the barrel again.
Amen.
We brought in the old dog to take care of us again this week. No mercy, and I'm glad we did. We're glad to welcome Sonny Miller. You guys know Sonny. You guys know his background. I won't get into reading the whole statement. The guy is a true believer and a great Christian man. Leather skills, arts, man of words. He's a guy that does a great job for us. And I'm glad we're here, that he's here, and I'm glad we're here to join him. So when you get a chance to see Sonny today, which I know the message will be great, please tell him hi and tell him thank you for being here again for us this week. Welcome, Sonny. Are there any more announcements or anything we need to be made aware of that's happening inside or outside our church today? Okay. Today we cry out to God for the life within these walls and beyond it. In the name of Christ, come and worship as we gather together today to share God's peace. May the peace of God be with you. So please take a moment to go around and say hi to everybody this morning, and we'll get back after it. Gus, how you doing, man? Hey, would you introduce yourself to this guy?
Good morning, sir.
Hey,
where are you going?
Look him in the eye, shake his hand, say, hey, I'm Gus Atkins. Good to see you, son.
Gus, what's on your shirt today, brother?
Oh, it's a toy. It's a toy.
Yeah, it wasn't a toy. Good morning.
At this moment, I'd ask if you could please stand for the call to worship and remain standing for the opening hymn of invocation. Please join with me. Our world offers many wide avenues and beautiful journeys to walk. Our society suggests we put down our roots in the shallow soil of pleasure and greed. Come and worship together. It's never easy for us to confess our sins, waiting God, There are hurts we are caused to our families and friends, which we would like to forget. There are those that believe in the it is impossible to love, and so we don't try. There are people that live on the edge of our society, and we ignore their cries for help. Forgive us, God, who comes near to us when we've lost our way. Show us yours. Lead us in humanity down the streets of your kingdom. Teach us the truth so that we might be able to keep your word revealed to us in Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Please be seated. Okay, we've got any children in the audience? Come on down.
Good morning.
Morning.
Look what I've got. What is that?
A present.
It's a present. When I walked into church this morning, it was sitting there in the pew, and I just happened to look, and it says, to Roxanna. Yippee, I've got a present. Do you think I should open it now? I don't know. Maybe I should wait till after church. What do you think? Can't hear anything. Do you hear anything?
Maybe it's has a wrapper on it, so like in case it's glass, it doesn't break.
Oh, okay. Well, feel of it though. It feels kind of light. Oh, let's just open it. Go ahead and open it.
Okay.
You can just. It's a box. We'll open it. What is it?
Nothing.
It's an empty box. Why would anybody give me an empty box? That's just odd, isn't it?
Yeah.
Let me think. I know. I think they gave me an empty box to remind me of something. I got it. They are trying to remind me. Do you know what this empty box is like? I get it now. It's like an empty promise. Do you know what an empty promise is?
No.
It's when you promise somebody something and you break it. That's a broken or an empty promise. So, have you ever broken a promise to anyone before?
No.
No? Well, this box, if you were to break a promise to somebody, that would be just about like handing them an empty box. You wouldn't want to do that, would you?
No.
No, I don't think so. In the Bible, in the book of Ecclesiastes, it says that, and I'm paraphrasing, that if you're going to make a promise, you better keep it. So I want you to remember this. Jesus made a lot of promises, but he kept every single one of them. So I want you to remember to keep your promises too, okay?
Okay.
Let us pray. Father, thank you for this time to be together. Remind us every single day that if we make a promise, we must keep it. In your holy name we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
Roxanne, you almost moved up on my hit list. If there had been a daggum toy in that box. But don't worry. Karen's mother and my mother are still intact. It causing trouble. So you're safe. As we prepare for today, let's lift up the people, those places and people that we want to hold near in our heart. If you know those people and you would like to put them on that prayer request, please find the cards in front of you in that pew and make sure that we get those so we can recognize those people and include them in our prayers. After communion, please make sure that if you want to do those things that you put those in our offering plate and get those things taken care of. And we continue to lift up in prayer Alice Hammond, Ben Henderson, Dennis Lott, George and B.J. Eastman, Janice Pursley, Pat, Allie, okay, thank you very much. Pat Allie, Susan Ferris, Tammy Schoenfeldt, West Texas and the Panhandle Fire victims, family of Debbie King, family of Annette Owen, family of Kim Carpenter, families of Nathan and George Ingram, the Moore, Hughes, and Davis families, the Pastoral Search Committee, and the JISD staff, students, and administration. May God be with all of us.
I'm going to ask y'all to just stand up, go to the center aisle. Now get to where you can hold somebody's hand.
Y'all good? I got Aunt Martha. Ready? Let's go to the Lord in prayer this morning. Morning, Father. What a beautiful day you
blessed us with. And my goodness, what a beautiful, beautiful time of the year that we are all enjoying and experiencing here this fine day. Father, as we come before you this morning, we just ask that you cover us with your love, your mercy, and your grace, and that this church body feels you and knows that you are covering each and every one of us as we touch, because we are one, we are whole within you. Father, we love you, we lift you on high, and it's in your Son's name we pray, and they all said, amen. Thank y'all.
I know you didn't expect that, and that's okay. I think we're going to do our Lord's Prayer now. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power,
and the glory forever. Amen.
Today's scripture lesson will come from Psalms chapter 32, 1 through 11. Happy are those whose transgression is forgiven, whose sin is covered. Happy are those to whom the Lord imputes not iniquity, and in whose spirit there is no deceit. While I kept silent, my body wasted away through the groaning all day long. For the day and night your hand was heavy upon me. My strength was dried up as by the heat of the summer. Selah. Then I acknowledged my sin to you, and I did not hide my iniquity. I said, I confess my transgressions to the Lord, and you forgave the guilt of my sin. Selah. Therefore, all who are faithful offer prayer to you. At the time of distress, the rush of the mighty waters shall not reach me. You are a hiding place for me. You preserve me from trouble. You surround me with the glad cries and deliverance. Selah. I will instruct you and teach you in the way you should go. I will counsel you with my eye open. Do not be like a horse or a mule without misunderstanding, whose temper must be curbed with bit and bridle, else it will not stay near you. Many torments in the wicked, but steadfast love surrounds those who trust in the Lord. Be glad in the Lord and rejoice, O righteous, and shout for joy. All you upright in heart, I apologize. For the word of the Lord, thanks be to God.
Can you guess? Anybody? Covered? What are we going to talk about today? Are you covered? What does covered mean? Like, I am worn out about hearing about tomorrow. You see, Craig knows. Anytime you don't have cover on your head, Craig, it absorbs a little faster on Craig, I think. I truly do. Tomorrow's the big day, right? The big eclipse. Oh, my. Oh, my. I heard him talking this morning on the news. What's going to happen to the zoo animals? How many of them will go into panic? And, oh, if you're at the zoo and you're there to help the animals. Well, you know, I'm sorry. I'm pretty simple. I'm kind of full of cowboy logic. And so it's going to be dark for like a few minutes. And it's not that I'm not excited about it, because I truly am. I remember seeing my first eclipse, partial eclipse, back in Hood County, Granbury, when I was just a kid, was in junior high. And the teachers got us out, and we did all this stuff with the paper and watching it on the ground. But some of us kids that had a little bit more knowledge brought Dad's welding helmet to school. Just looked through the lens and, you know, all is well. But I think we've been covered for days and days and days about this eclipse and all the things that it's going to do for us, all of the things that it's going to share and bring together. Yet tomorrow we're probably going to be covered with some clouds. Tomorrow evening we're going to be covered with rainstorms, I hope, because as I walk in this morning, Bob tells me, he says, water in the bar ditches up there just north of the house a little bit. I drove to town last night to get covered in the rain because I knew it wasn't going to rain at the ranch, but I wanted to wash the bugs that covered my windshield off my truck. There was a family that went traveling. They actually went to Jerusalem, husband, wife, her mom. And as they're traveling, the unthinkable strikes. And the mother-in-law unexpectedly passes away while they're in Jerusalem. Being the good doting son, he wanted to make sure he had all bases covered. So he goes down to the American consulate, goes to visiting with them. They go to run through all the details, sign all the paperwork to get the loved one back here to the States. The advisor says, sir, I'm sorry, but this is going to cost you a little over $5,000 to get her back. What was your business while you were here in Jerusalem? He asked. And the son lifts his head and he says, you know, we were just walking the path, going along. Just one of the bucket lists in life, just to see where Jesus walked and taught, lived his life. And now she's lost hers. He said, well, that sounds like a faith-based trip. It sounds like you're a faith-based individual. And he says, yes, yes, very much so. Our family all believe. We're all covered in the blood. He says, well, you know, he says, I don't want you to think this sounds the wrong way, but you could have a burial service for her right here in Jerusalem and leave her here on this hallowed ground. And it'd only cost you $150, not $5,000. Son kind of downs his head a minute, thinks, raises his head back up. He goes, you know, I appreciate that offer. And the counselor says, did you just go into a moment of prayer? If you did, what did God tell you about that? He says, you know, I said, I didn't really think about it that way, but I guess I was in this moment of meditation. He says, no, we're going to take her home. We're going to take her back to the United States. He said, sir, I got to know. I got to understand why. And he says, well, y'all have a little bit of a reputation here. And the counselor backs up and says, what are you talking about? And he says, see, Craig's ahead. He already knows where we're headed. He goes, funny guys always know, right? And he says, you know, he says, that reputation is y'all can kill somebody and you can bury them and they'll rise again. And he says, I love my mother-in-law, but I just can't take that chance again by leaving her here behind. Are you covered? Were you covered? I knew I had Craig covered. I knew it. When I prayed many days ago about the topic of this message today and the eclipse and the coverage and as we went through Holy Week and, oh, my goodness, the job these men did at Maundy Thursday over at the Methodist Church. Oh, my goodness. What a special evening that was. And if you weren't there, I wish you had been. But we're covered with the love and our Savior. But as I prayed about that topic last Sunday, as we sat at a beautiful family table that was covered in every perfect thing that you could imagine, and as we shared an unbelievable feast, there was a lady that made a comment, and I go, yeah, God, I got it. I've been listening. I promise you I've been listening. And she made a comment about an instrument that is so special in her life, and it's so special in each one of your lives, and it covers you every time you grace that threshold. And she was telling me about this instrument that has to be rebuilt in a certain location by a certain way, covered by the expertise of an individual that knows how to relay those ivories on those keys. Can you imagine the amount of hours and the amount of days and weeks and months that that instrument had been covered in order to play long enough and enough practice sessions and enough family gatherings that those keys would actually have to be recovered? Now look, in my day-to-day world, it's pretty easy. We recover the sole of our boots often. Like me and Cater, we got half a dozen pair down here at the boot repair man right now getting recovered. We'll recover a saddle horn on our saddle because we get into a wreck or the mesquites get thick or a colt will rear up and flip over and roll on it, or heavens to Betsy that the moths will get to the bottom of your saddle and eat the sheepskin lining out of the skirts of your saddle. What are you covered in and how do you get covered? And all of the coverings that we talk about, the windows are covered with beautiful stained glass. The walls are covered with beautiful tapestry. Our phones are covered with a phone case. We'll cover our bodies with clothes because we figured out early on in Genesis, naked wasn't good because that first sin came along. And Psalms, and just to tie back to the last time I was here, when we talked about a young lady named Fanny Crosby, but Psalms is an amazing, amazing book within the book that you should live in and stay within, you know, and the authors, David, Solomon, Asaph, sons of Korah, and others. And it was written 1,000 to 300 years BC. The key verse in Psalms, though, is 19:14. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. You need to be covered in that verse. You need to live your life to be covered. I think back to all the romance of the rodeo world and the Western world. And, you know, when you talk to a bull rider these days, did you cover? That means, did you ride? Yeah, I got him covered. If you think back even longer, maybe 160, 70 years ago, how many people came here in a covered wagon? If you think back to the great Western Chisholm, John Chisholm, Craig could probably sing the song for us, I would guess. We don't need to this morning. But Billy the Kid, as he runs out to battle the outlaws, although an outlaw he was made to be, he yelled at Pat Garrett, "Cover me, Pat," as he went. How many times have you seen a movie, "Cover me"? Those are the things that we ask for every day in our lives, especially in our cowboy life. You know I'm covered at the ranch because of Brent and because of Max and because of Kenzie and because of Hunter. We cover each other's backs, yet the ranch is covered in amazing grass right now because we've been covered with the rain. I know you know where I'm headed. You got to know whether you're covered or not. But it's more important that if you know you're covered, you got to make sure you don't have Roxanna's empty box. You got to make sure that everyone around you has a full promise from you that you are going to make sure they too are covered. I don't care if it's the mailman. I don't care if it's the bald-headed guy that sets up on as close to the front row as he can. I don't care who you are. Make sure you help everyone else in your life and in your surrounding be covered. Make sure that as you walk day in and day out, whether you're celebrating a birthday, maybe like Monty is. I don't think Monty's celebrating a birthday today, but in case he was. But Cindy had her birthday last Wednesday. Coverage. Most people today, men at least, they'll have some kind of coverage on their face. Some of us, the handsome ones, me and Bob, we're clean shaven, but we're still covered, and we're covered with the blood of Jesus. We're covered with the grace and the promise of the book that we live through, but yet we all stumble and fall. Just because you stumble and fall, don't you dare for one split second think that you can't step right back up and keep living the life that God blesses us with. He's had so many opportunities to take me. Head injuries and horse wrecks and tractor wrecks and everything in the book you can think of. But every time I woke up, thank you, Lord. You covered me one more day. You covered me one more day to make sure that I get to come help you be covered one more time. Fanny Crosby was the reference. And in this patriotic translation of the NIV that I have that I just love this version. It talks about what Psalms is and how things move along, but Cater reminded me I was on the clock today and made me think about another situation that a lady's dress should be long enough to cover the subject, but short enough to keep it interesting. We're going to close with this. One of America's most beloved sacred lyricists, Fanny Crosby, no doubt received much of her mentoring from time spent in the Book of Psalms. Despite the fact that she was blind from infancy, she went on to pen more than 8,000 songs of praise to God, including such classic hymns as Near the Cross, Praise Him, and To God Be the Glory. The chorus of one of her most well-known hymns, Blessed Assurance, we sang that three Sundays ago, sums up the theme of Psalms. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. My mother loved that song. Sang it just like a songbird. There is a lady that covers us every Sunday morning at 10:45. One of those two instruments will start a note. And if you can get Craig Adkins to jump to attention and be in the right spot with just the note, what a covering that is. She sits behind me today. And she sits there every Sunday. And until I had heard her play Jesus Loves Me, as I'd asked several Sundays ago on the piano, that instrument is so amazing. But her talent is even more amazing because it's a God-given covered talent. You probably don't think this might be a special day for some people, but every time that I get to stand here in front of you or sit there listening to someone else speak the right words from here, I watch her and I think about the dedication and the coverage. So, one more time today, I'm going to ask you guys to stand right now. We're going to offer a little hand clap for Aunt Martha and her coverage of the music. You guys can be seated. She is so special, and I know y'all know that. I know I'm preaching to the covered choir this morning. But she is an amazing individual. And the more I'm around her and with her and talk to her, it just covers my heart in love. A love that is truly a blessing. So as we leave here today, y'all give her a little hug, a little neck wringing. Don't cover too deep at one time because we all have to breathe. But for every breath you're blessed with and every blessing of breath that you can share the word of God with someone else, I just ask and encourage you to do that at whatever level you can. If somebody is here today that they're struggling and they need a little redemption, then all you got to do is speak it. All you got to do is say, Lord Jesus, come into my heart today. And he'll do that for you. But you gotta be covered in the commitment. Because his commitment and God's love for us is what gets us through the day. You may think it's the phone or the computer or the iPad. I know my team, our team at the ranch, gets us through every single day. And the team that's here from Davo and the team in the back running the AV for those that aren't with us here today but are with us in spirit, because they're covered with the message today through today's technology that covers and eats us up. If you know somebody that may not be covered the right way, and especially for tomorrow's big event, if they're in harm's way, help cover them. Get them out of that way. Get them out of that harm's way and get them back into the love of Jesus Christ. Talk to them. Do with them whatever you need to get them convinced. I love each and every one of you for sitting here this morning and listening to me. God and I have been tussling for a lot of years. The day he figures out that I've covered enough and it's time for him to cover me and take me home, what a blessing and a glory that will be. But he's going to leave y'all behind, and it's up to you to keep filling that. Be covered in the love and the mercy and the peace that he brings to us. Can you do that for me? I know you can. Y'all bow your heads with me real quick. Morning again, Lord. Yeah, it's just me. Father, I know that you're all over me and you've got me covered better than anything that I could ever have dreamed. Father, thank you for that sacrifice and that blessing that you gave. But Lord, thank you for getting up out of that tomb and showing all the naysayers that you truly were the risen Son. For Father, we will never be able to repay that. Father, we thank you and we love you. And it's in your Son's name we pray. Amen. This time today we're covered with, this is the joyful feast of the people of God. And it's according to the scripture within Luke. When our risen Lord was at the table with his disciples, he took bread, he blessed it, and he broke it, and he gave it to them. Then their eyes were opened and they recognized him. This is the Lord's table. Our Savior invites those who trust him to share in the feast that he has prepared. So as our elders and deacons lead us this morning in this very special time of each Sunday as we come together, we just ask that you remember that risen time.
O God of guidance and care, help us resist the temptation to set aside the joy and wonder of Easter and to resume the dull, safe routines of lives that aren't touched by your Spirit. Help us to remember that as you, we must obey, not the pressures of the world. As we eat this bread, help us recall that Christ did what Christ did for us. Help us to accept our role to draw the world to your love. Help us find the nourishment to serve you with faithfulness. We pray in the name of the one who was faithful to us, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for this special time in our faith, a time we can come before you and closely examine our lives. In doing so, we eat the bread and drink of the cup. Thank you as we carefully reflect upon ourselves, we know that we're unworthy of this, yet you love us enough to allow us to eat the bread, which represents your body, and drink the wine, which represents your blood. And we are forever grateful for this. In your holy name we pray. Amen.
God, we have been made in your image. So, in your generosity, make us generous for your work. In your faithfulness, make us faithful. So that whatever gift we bring to you might be an offer of worship before you, just as the gold and the frankincense and the myrrh were before your Son, Jesus Christ, and in whose name we pray. Amen.
Amen.